And so now, in the wake of the death of a British monarch, Americans, particularly American Indians, what do we have to say about that? Do we know what the monarchy has meant to our people? As we mourn, realizing that we were made the lowest of slaves in our own country, on our own land, on our own soil. As we mourn, being reclassified in ways that took us outside of the Constitution, in ways that ultimately led to us being seen and referred to as African. As we mourn the many generations of our own family members who had no clue that they were slaves to a British monarchy, do we have room or tears enough to mourn this death? Well, I don't think we do. The pain of being denationalized and made slave fodder as well as prison fodder, because the system that was redone to kick us off our land is that brutal, that we are basically seen as unwanted on our own land, as the foreigner comes here and looks down at us, the ones whose land they are or have come to reap the benefits of. And it's not over. The death of a monarch doesn't mean that the oppression stops. Doesn't mean that your wealth is still not being siphoned off of. So what does it mean to us as American Indians particularly? It means we need to buckle down, stop crying for others when we're the ones that need the tears shed. Death only happens once to human beings. But when you've been denationalized, your death is daily. Your oppression is daily. Your rights are stripped daily. It's an ongoing death. There's not enough tears for that either. So, on this day, on the death of a monarch, we gather our lessons. Lessons learned. No more will we allow any monarchs or any church cults any major monotheistic entity that has taken or believes that they have taken ownership of our very souls lessons learned, we will never again be so blind as to trust vipers. Never again will we turn our back and believe that those draped in holy robes and robes of nobility are actually holy or noble. And as I've said in several of my videos, it is time for the American Indian to reduce their worship of the oppressor's book they call the Bible. It is time to reduce that worship and that reading to one verse. The verse that speaks to when those who are unrighteously oppressed have the dominion to break the yoke of those who through deception and trickery and treachery rendered us their slaves in their own what they call holy book. So we grab that one passage that speaks to that emancipation. That scripture at Genesis 27:40 that I've spoken many times about. When you shall have the dominion, you will break the yoke of Jacob and all his machinations off your neck. So lessons learned on this day of death. No longer will we be seen as dead or dead entities as we live on our own land. No longer will we be tricked by those who've never meant us well. Let this day remind us that we still have work to do in becoming the sovereigns that we declared that we are. In our Declaration of Independence, that was a declaration for all who live on our soil. But now we require that you not just live here, but that you respect the indigenous of the land, the American Indian who has been reclassified as your Negro, your colored, you're black, you're African American. No longer are we those things. Those of us who are heirs to our great legacy, it is us who know what I'm talking about. It is us who will reclaim our legacy, our birthright, for all our ancestors. Now and forever. Thank you.